All right, so I'm going to be building an end-to-end agentic automation in 15 minutes. My name is Taiki Yoshida. I'm part of the Power Platform Product Engineering team here at Microsoft. So what you're going to be learning is what is the art of the possible? We're going to be highlighting about various different capabilities in both Power Automate as well as Copilot Studio to build an agentic automation. I want to tell you what's the difference between rule-based automation and also goal-based automation. When do you really use what in these kind of different capabilities? And so I want to really first explain about the problem that I'm going to use as a scenario here. So in this particular scenario, there is a sales support team who's helping different sellers across the globe. And they basically have to access various different systems. For example, manufacturing systems that is built on-prem. There's a sales invoice systems that's built on SaaS, and all these different pieces. And really, you have to have different screens, right, for all of these different pieces. So it takes a lot of time to really gather all the information that's required when a customer asks for any information. So instead of doing all of this manually, we're going to build an agent in now about 13 minutes from scratch using mainly on Copilot Studio by hooking up to different various capabilities, including the computer use agents. All right, so with 12 minutes remaining, let me go and switch over to my demo. Now, I gotta pray that it's gonna work. So here I've got this blank slate. I wanna build a new agent here using Copilot Studio. In this audience, who's actually touched Copilot Studio before? All right, maybe just a half. So Copilot Studio actually has capability Copilot built in. So what you can do is actually go and explain what you wanna build as an agent. I see it's a little bit small, so I wanna make it bigger. So I wanna say, okay, what do you want it to do? And I wanna first say, for example, support product orders from customers. And you basically have to just chat your way through to really make all of the specifications. And here it's gonna probably ask me what's the name of the agent. So I'm gonna name it Mona for now, just to kind of keep things personal, so I can just blame Mona instead of blaming this agent. And here, what should Mona do? And I'm gonna say, yeah, this example should be good. So this is good, yeah. And then it'll carry on. It'll maybe ask for maybe references to different data sources. In this particular case, I'm going to make a custom one, so I'm going to leave it as it is. I'm going to switch over to configure, and now it's already created all of the instructions that I'll need to run this agent. But in this particular scenario, I actually want to make something custom. So let me just go and click on continue and start building my agent. And now, as you see in this overview, it's got the same instructions and such. I'm just going to delete this for a second. And I want to name, instructions here. I want to add a new set of instructions, okay? Today, because I want to use all of the different capabilities that I want to add on top of them here. So the instruction is going to basically reference all these different pieces. So in this particular case, I have a sales function. When it asks for a price or quotes, it'll go and look up a sales note. So the sales note I've actually prepared here in this Word doc. As you see, the sales guy has made a very interesting note here. It's very easy to read, right? So the salesperson has to go and look this up. Every single time there's a discount or something, I have to look it up in here. Now, the next one is if I ask for status on existing orders, I can go and look it up to an API. I want to make a custom API on this. And I'm also going to use a computer using agents for anything that's maybe not in US dollars, but maybe in Japanese yen, I'm Japanese, maybe Japanese yen or euros or something. I'm going to also add a function in inventory and manufacturing to go and check on existing inventory from a very old school ERP system that I have built on 1990s when I was born. And I'm also going to add a couple of general prompts as well here in to keep it professional, keep it friendly when it's responding to my thing. So I'm just going to clean that up. There you go. And that's it. All right, now, so my next step is to then actually start adding more capabilities to the agent. And next, I'm going to add a trigger. So in this case, I'm going to add an email trigger here. I can add a trigger from rich seller libraries. We actually have 1,300 different connectors you can go and plug it into. In this particular case, I'm going to use a shared inbox. So I'm going to put shared inbox in here. I need to change my filter. It says, OK, when a new email arrives in my shared inbox, I'm going to click next. And behind the scenes, it's basically making kind of an agent flow that would have a trigger to go and then run this Copilot agent. So it's just going to take its time. tick tock, tick tock. This is the scary thing about doing a live demo because it's taking its time. And now it's gonna use my credentials here. Right when a new email arrives and next. All right, and I'm gonna just specify my email address, all right, that I made for this demo, and create trigger. Okay, that's done. So now whenever I receive an email, it'll go and trigger this agent. So now it's gonna be kind of an autonomous agent, right, on its own. Now I'm gonna add more capabilities. Now, you know, there's gonna be a lot of questions coming from the, you know, the customers. So I wanna make sure that you can now answer different, knowledge based articles. So in this particular case, I've got this sales note I just already talked to you about. I also got this Contoso-Sabat catalog, which is beautifully made by me using, you know, Gen AI capabilities. I've got these custom pens and mugs and notebooks and such. You know, that's you can make custom made, right? It's a swag shop. So here I've done and added a trigger. So I'm going to go and add the knowledge. So I want to disable the web search because I don't want to go external. I just want to look only into the internal systems and add the knowledge here. In this particular case, I'm just going to use my OneDrive. Just make things simple. But you can use SharePoint. You can use Azure. You can have various different sources that you can use to create as a RAG. So in this OneDrive, I got my demo here, and I'm going to add my sales notes. And in the sales note, I'll have sources of information. Okay, this is control 5. I'm just making sure that the Copilot Studio can understand what this is about. So this is for referring to my discounts. And now I'm gonna add another one for my specifications, right? So come on, quickly. I got 7 minutes left. It's taking time. While I wait, so all of the, you know, responsible AI capabilities, right, is actually built into this Copilot Studio. So we've already done all the things that, like, for example, protecting you from jailbreak, having like injection prompts, all of that is already in this Copilot Studio. So you don't have to focus on all of that pieces because we'll handle it for you, right? You just got to focus on building the logic. Now, please work. It's just adding a OneDrive. Come on. All right. Okay, if it doesn't answer back to me in 15 seconds, I'm going to switch to my backup because it's just taking too long. Okay, it's listen to me. So I've got the sales notes, and I'm going to skip that other piece on adding the OneDrive. It's the same process. So now I'm going to add new capabilities to it, which is now, first off, the API. So I built this API on Azure beforehand, and it's just a simple gets and post request that you can go and receive and send, right? You can use any APIs you want. You can even hook it up to Azure API Management if you wanted to. But basically, I'm going to build a custom connector. So in this new tool, I have the custom connector. And I want to click. Oh, there's a pop-up here that is showing up. And basically, if you have like a Swagger definition, right, you can actually directly import this and then start using it today. Like, it takes literally like 30 seconds. And that's what I'm going to show you in a minute if it shows up. So given interest of time, I only have 5 minutes to demo. So I've got this imported order management, which I've done previously. I'm just going to show you what it's done. As you can see here, it's got the host, the exact same one I had on my Azure. If you have authentication, or if you have API keys, you'll define it in the security. And you basically define different actions in this custom connector. And that's how kind of it works. I don't know why it's popping up this. But basically, this is how it's set up. And once you set this up, then you start seeing it show up in here as well. So OK, give me a second. All right. All right, so once I've added this, what I can do is go back to the tools, and then I can start searching for get. Oh, there's something wrong on my keyboard. And if I go and search for it, these are the two ones that I just added from my custom connector, okay? So if I go and add get orders, it'll build the connection. So if you have it in OAuth, it'll automatically use the end user's authentication as well. So I'll just add this to my agent. I got 4 minutes. All right. So now I've added my custom connector. I'm going to now add also a new capability called agent flows. This is something that GA'd about a month ago. So I'm going to add it as a new tool. And agent flow basically allows you to build intelligent automation that's kind of more in the deterministic side of things, right? You might want to add AI pieces to it. So in this case, whenever an agent flow would then, agent calls this agent flow, you can then define a deterministic kind of steps on what you want to do next. So in this particular case, I want to go and add an input for escalation. So if you have maybe from with a manufacturing team, you want to make an approval request for your exception. So I want to go and add here and say, I want to add request the details of the exception. I can't type. And then I've got the quantity as well, sorry, here. I'll name it the quantity. And then now I can then use these variables that or inputs, right, I just defined. And in this new capability called human in the loop, right, there's now a new section and we have a new capability called advanced approvals, which allows you to then add multiple stages in your approval process. We used to have this as a, you know, a standard approvals action. Now you can actually make and define multiple stages in here, right? I'm not going to do a full end-to-end demo here on what you can do, but you basically define each of the steps like manager approval, director approval. You can also go and define things like add conditions to it. In my other one here, what will be upcoming soon is we'll also bring intelligent approval. So the AI will actually make decisions on behalf of it, which we don't have today, but we will be coming to bring this as well as one of the roadmap capabilities where the AI will decide based on the inputs and the information that you provided, it'll make the decisions automatically. So you don't have to have the approval process every single time beforehand. You can have the AI to do it first, to do a pre-screening and then go into the next one. All right, so going back to my other one. So now I've defined this agent flows and if I go and publish this, right? And I know I haven't got everything set up in this particular scenario. Sorry, I don't have the time. But in the space of the last 2 minutes, I'm going to build a computer using agents. All right, so going back to my other one. All right, go back to the agent. Now that I've defined deterministic automations, I've also gone and defined the tools to connect to my APIs. The last piece is I'm going to add a new capability to add computer use agents. All right. And this is a new capability that we announced, I think, about a couple of weeks ago. Now we're bringing this as a frontier capability. And now what you can do is you can hook this up to any on-prem system like here, right? Where you have like really old system like this. Who's seen like something like this, right? Where you don't have APIs, where you don't have like a team that want to go and modernize it, I can just go and use this computer use capability to then define it as we go along. So given the interest of time, I'm now going to switch over to my backup because I just don't have enough time. So I've got this manufacturing order computer use agents. I got a currency converter computer use agents. And if I go and open up here, you see that I've defined it in instructions here like so. And now I'm going to use the email that I received in my mailbox. Okay, as a trigger. So here, I'm going to go back and say, using the trigger from that I got earlier on at 1:40, basically it was an email asking for, I want to quote, I want to see how long it takes to do an order. And this would start running. Let's go and run this on. Let's go back. Come on. Come on. Literally got a few minutes left. All right, so now it's now gathering all of the tools I embedded into this demo here. It's going and picked up all of the different knowledge bases. It's now using this email I've got here, right? Asking, can you provide price code for 150 t-shirts? And if there's any discounts, and can you give me an estimated delivery date, right? So now it's gone and looked up the sources. It's gone and started spinning up the manufacturing order computer use agents.
Taiki, are you able to wrap it up?
In 30 seconds. Give me 30 seconds. And it'll go and then trigger the machine, which is now going to run this. And now it's following the instructions on computer use agents, as you see here, and it's actually doing it on behalf of you. So whatever, you know, order details that you had, you'll just pass it over to here, and it'll just basically do something on-prem and then go back to it as well. So now you see it's an end-to-end agentic automation. And sorry, it's only 15 minutes. I hope you got the gist of what's going to happen. I'll be over there in the booth if you want to go and do a deep dive on a session. So thank you very much for listening. All right.